back to the Steph and Dom show.
Love it.
Thoroughly good bit of good bit of thing there, whatever it is.
Music, darling. That's
yes,
the one.
Very nice. If you want to get involved, the number to call is over.
People would probably have a perception from wherever they've seen us that, you know, we live a very privileged life.
Brandy today, are you?
No, brandy. Oh, a little bit brandy.
That we don't have a care in the world, that, you know, live in a love, great big house, and all we do is lark about. And, you know, as with everybody, it is far from the truth. And we've had great sadness for a very long time, and great pain, and we carry that pain daily.
We just hide it very well.
We just hide it very well, and we hide it through laughter.
Honor.
And who's with Honor, Max?
Honor will be his day.
Our son, Max, he's 18. He has a very severe form of epilepsy that he's had since he was 4 months old.
What is Honor?
Up to 100 seizures a day.
It has damaged his brain and it's damaged his life. He has a mental age of 5, 6, maybe.
Honor!
Where is she?
There's Anna. Anna!
Hi, Miss Max.
Hi, darling.
Have you moved on?
It is quite like a difficult thing to comprehend because he does look so normal.
You can take it with me. Take that bit. Good boy.
Good boy, Max.
There you go.
Good boy.
But Max needs a lot of support.
Press the button. Press the button.
And it is quite difficult for everyone to give him that.
Really well done, Maxie.
The worst case scenario for Max is sudden, unexplained death in epilepsy.
You come to do your work?
You come to do some work?
They have a big seizure and they never wake up.
Right here.
As he reaches adulthood, the risk of this goes up considerably.
I'll be surprised in a minute.
Yeah.
He's been on medication since he was 4, and not one of them has managed to get his seizures under control.
What do you fancy, Maxie?
You want some bread?
Yeah. And there's going to be some bread in 1 minute.
The bread's coming, I promise.
Bread in 1 minute, Maxie. It's just cooking. But there's a new product coming to market that could be really good for Max.
We can't access it in the UK.
Well, the possible miracle cure seems to be a byproduct of marijuana.
Rub-a-dub-dub, thanks for the grub. It's hit the press. Now is the time for us to be able to try and find out what it's all about.
It's a good sign.
Yeah. Ow, what's...
Sorry.
What's all this?
You don't want to look at that.
Wow, 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 wow. Me with my dark hair. No, look, aren't we beautiful? And young.
Well, you. God, who's that? Oh, God, that's me.
Shut up. Did you not recognise yourself?
Not really.
This one's going to kill you.
Oh, no.
Back in the day. It is a bonkers story how we met. His friend, and he said, I've met the guy you're going to marry. And both of us sort of went,
I don't think so, yeah. And no, I don't think we've gone to bed yet. Look at those eyes.
4 months later, I'd sold up everything, and within 2 years, we were married. Good old days, hey, Dom.
Max is going to sit down.
Are you going to sit down and look at the pictures with us?
All right, you can look at the pictures with us. Okay.
Get a bit of knee space. Who's that, Max?
And we fell pregnant.
Max.
There's another one. With
Max is a baby. Max.
Max.
Max Parker.
You know, we came back from the hospital. We put Max on the coffee table in his car seat and went outside, got a very large drink, stared at him through the window.
What do we do now?
Who is that luscious creature leaning up against the palm tree?
Oh, that's you.
Oh, that must be me. See you later, Max.
Bye, Maxie.
Oh, he's so beautiful.
Look at that, 18 months old, and I've already started to go grey.
Well, you would have done, after all that stuff we went through.
Well, I was changing his nappy one evening. I mean, you might not believe it, but I did, on a fairly regular basis. And there was a fun little movement. I thought, it's a bit odd.
His little face, all worried. Took him to the GP, at which point he went, oh, I don't like the look of that, and said, I might be wrong, but I think this is a thing called West syndrome, infantile spasms. I've never seen it before. It's very rare. As he was getting bigger and bigger, his seizures were becoming much more violent. They were saying the damage that happens at this young age is catastrophic to the brain. It is a death, pretty much, really. You know, it feels like that. It feels like the death of the future of the child, and that child is not going to have a normal life. Look at him. I mean, that absolutely epitomises who he would have been.
What am I going to do?
What are you going to do? What do you want?
He's going to go and get Edward. He wants to do some fevering.
Why are you away in a minute? I'll do vacuum cleaning.
That'd be fantastic. Oh, look at
cool.
You.
Cool!
You superstar.
Cool!
It's incredibly difficult to know how to treat him.
That's it, calm down.
We're guided by his consultant.
Good boy.
Hi, hi, hi.
Hi there.
Hi.
Good boy, Maxie.
Ready?
I'm just pairing with the walls.
Yeah.
Kapow!
So in terms of auto-stims, i.e. the device activating itself in response to perceived seizures based on heart rate fluctuations, is doing that 140 times a day.
Right.
Really?
Now,
that's quite a lot.
Last time it was 128.
So it's gone up. I have to say, I think you're probably looking at a quarter of what is actually going on, particularly overnight. I don't think they were... Where he goes.
There we go.
Here we go. Right, now we're going into our climby backy.
Hang on.
It's all right, baby. Mummy's got you.
And is this when he will usually come out of it and then go back into another
one? He's still in it.
What's the
matter? All right, darling.
Brett, I would wait till he stops coughing. We have to be honest and acknowledge that patients with severe refractory epilepsy are at risk of death, suddenly, often in the context of a severe seizure.
Yeah.
And it's very difficult to talk about that, but our policy is to be transparent
Definitely.
About it and to talk about the risks and what we can do to minimise those risks.
We're going to do your height and weight, big fella, and then we're going to go and get a drink. Nice cold drink.
He has never stopped seizing from the age of about four.
Yeah.
So he's been on medication since he was four, and not one of them has managed to get his seizures under control. So we have tried pretty much every single one out there.
Well, basically, these are the four drugs that Max is currently on a daily basis. Every time we've tried a new drug, there's always a little bit of hope that comes with it. And we've been going through, you know, trying drugs, dumping them, trying them again.
And all the while, he's getting worse.
And all the while, but he's just not moving on.
No. Dizzy and drowsy, irritable and weak, which I would completely agree with. Slurred speech.
are the main side effects of that. It is incredible how much toxin a child can take. That's the one they give to death row inmates to send them off to sleep before they kill them. Nice.
Probably more than a, was that a 10 mil dose?
Oh, I would think so, yes. Try it and see.
Thanks. Maybe later, eh? If there was nothing wrong with you and you were taking those things, you might start behaving like Max.
But what's your point?
My point is that those three could be causing more trouble than they're solving.
I know, but they might be saving his life and stopping him from having one big one which he doesn't wake up from. I mean, we have this conversation 3, 4, 5 times a year, and we always end up here. We have to be able to try and find a choice. There has to be another solution.
The government is to make it easier for doctors to prescribe medicines derived from cannabis. The products will be made available on prescription across the UK later this year. The move follows high-profile cases involving children with severe epilepsy being denied access to cannabis oil.
Good shot, Daddy.
Red's on her.
Red's on her. She's coming. I don't think we're going to do... Oh, yeah. That's it. That's it. Bit more. Done it. Lovely. In principle, it's a bit of a red letter day if we can find the right stuff that works for Max. Oh, good shot, Max.
The anecdotal information coming through is raising hope for us. You know, the child who has 300 seizures a day takes it once and never has another seizure. You know, that, I mean, that's miracle stuff. Mm. But I want to know that that's a fact.
Max, you're getting... Run in. Run in, run in. Oh, nice one. Back of the net. In an ideal world...
How's that, Maxie? Still hot?
I'd quite like to be able to bring those seizures down, improve his quality of life, and to be able to have a conversation with him.
Yeah. I'd like to think that he can actually have a social life and friends and interact with other people, and think that's the thing I want most for him, really.
And if one or two drops of oil could take these things out of his body, I'd be the happiest man alive.
I can't look at it. I literally can't look at it.
That's a bit of hope too far,
yeah,
possibly.
Can't.
A bit of hope too far, but that would be nice.
I've never felt brave enough to face up to this head on until now.
Move on.
Why? I don't know. I don't know what's changed. Possibly because I feel a glimmer of hope that we've never had before, ever. That something might actually help. Yeah, the job's not done yet.
No, come on. Find out. Good morning and welcome to the Steph and Dom Show on this mediocre Sunday.
Well, I'm just going to say a quick good morning, Maxie Pax. Good morning, Maxie, it's Mummy.
Do you want to take this off? Because you might get spikes in it. You want to watch the cricket? Perfect. You do that. You're more than capable. And off we go. Such thick hair. And it grows like daddy's, like a walnut whip. The joy we get from Max really is watching him express himself in any way he wants, whenever he wants.
Good
nice
shot.
One, Max. Nice. Flipping
murder.
He will sit for hours and hours and hours and watch a sport, be it cricket, tennis, rugby, football. You know, I've even caught him watching darts, for goodness sake. Greatest swimmers. You're hilarious. Since when have you ever watched anything to do with swimming?
You're going to carry your golf bag? Come on, then. Carry your golf bag. Come on, then, dude. You're going to... Right, am I taking it, then? I'll be your caddy. Go on, then.
Ah!
Shh! Max! Max! Little voice, buddy. Shh! Inside voice. Good boy.
He goes like, yes! When he's really happy.
Dad! Shh! Little voice, buddy, little voice.
He expresses it in different ways. He goes like that, or he'll shout really loudly, like, yeah.
that.
Yes! Right, I'm gonna have a shot.
Go on then. You do a good shot.
Big one.
Big one. Wow!
Cool!
There's an innocent, pure joy about him. I mean, it's not the greatest haircut in the world. That's a given. Right, let's get you into the bath. How does that feel?
Where's Anna?
She's on her way from the village.
In the family, it's always been us two. Because Mummy and Daddy, with their work and things like that, they often have to dash off places.
These rhinos!
These rhinos? Wanna come sit down?
Look, these rhinos!
I've always been there for him, and I've always been his solid, like, person.
That's Martin Johnson.
That is Martin Johnson. Who's this?
Australia.
Australia? What about? Do you want to pick the page?
She doesn't shy away. She's not embarrassed by him, ever.
That's so cool.
She's very, very protective of him.
Mm.
And they have the most unique bond I've ever seen. I mean, he's absolutely adores everything. Where, you know, he wants to know where she is at every given stage of the day. And wants to be with her all the time. As long as she's in the room, he's a happy boy.
What's Will's gonna think?
What do you think?
Pappy's not funny.
Pappy's not funny. Do you think Pappy's sleeping?
Pappy's sleeping.
Do you think he's snoring?
What if Pappy is watching?
I think Pappy's watching the football.
Watching the football on the computer?
Yeah, he's watching football on the computer.
What's Billy watching?
I think Billy's watching Huddersfield Giants.
On Super League?
Yeah.
Granny Pig is watching the football.
Granny Pig is watching the football.
I sometimes think, like, why was it him? Why wasn't it me? He's got his own little world. He's happy in his world, but his world is very small.
Nicky's got a brother balls on.
Nicky has got a brother balls on. What do you think I'm going to wear?
Catalan Dragons.
Catalan Dragons? What do you think? Do you think Granny's going to be wearing Manchester United?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah, so it has been difficult, but I just try and accept him for who he is and be there for him, because I can't really do anything else. So, yeah.
Jesus,
what? Oh, dear. That nearly went. Oh. Do you care if we mind your fingers? Well, give it a try.
Okay,
finally
doing
it! Scoop the shot! I know, I am unbelievably, yeah.
Yes! Yes!
Boogie? A boogie. Oh, that worked.
You can put down your lights on!
I still don't think I would necessarily trust medical marijuana if I haven't actually done a bit of research to find out if we give it to him, is he going to be dancing around with the fairies all the time? As the two main ingredients in the cannabis plant, it can be easy to confuse CBD and THC. They're not the same thing. THC can send you soaring on a high, while CBD is reassuringly non-psychoactive.
CBD can still be sold as long as claims are not made about their medical benefits. Sue gave me some. Do you remember when we started this?
Yeah, that she can buy on the high street. What is it? Have you still got it?
Yeah, I've got it upstairs. Okay, so this...
Oh, that's it. That's what we're looking at.
It doesn't tell us why you'd want it.
That's exactly what I'm looking at.
Is it?
Right, well, it's labelled here as a 5% CBD food supplement. But it doesn't actually say what it's meant to do.
No.
Put a few drops under the tongue 2 to 3 times a day. Maximum 10 drops a day. This is perfectly legal.
If you can buy that on the high street, can I just give that to Max? And would it affect his epilepsy? I'm getting quite confused.
Cheers, Maxie. Where's your lemon?
I need to ask David, his consultant, because obviously he knows the science and we don't.
Okay, just so we can put this to bed, we managed to pick that up in a high street shop.
Right.
What is the difference then?
This product does have cannabinoids in it. Mm-hmm. And they are a very low dose, mm-hmm. probably something like 1/100th of what we would use for wow. treatment. So this is allowed legally because it's below the cutoff.
Yeah.
There's pretty much nothing in it.
It's
very little in it.
Yeah.
So it's unlikely that it would be effective. So what I'd say first of all is there's a lot of hype about the cannabis-based products at the moment. From the evidence we have, they're not a silver bullet, and we don't know what the long-term effects will be.
Yeah.
Having said that, the studies do suggest that even allowing for those side effects, there have been patients that have had improvement in things like quality of life, alertness because their seizure count goes
yeah.
down, mm-hmm. sleep, which I know is a real issue for
yeah.
Max. Mm-hmm. I think it has promise.
Okay.
And I think Max is in one of the groups
luckily
for whom that promise exists.
Brilliant.
Ready? Ready, ready, ready?
If we're going to try and give Max medical marijuana, I think it would be very beneficial to actually speak to someone who's done it and understand what they've been through and how well it's worked.
Wow!
12-year-old Billy Caldwell suffers from life-threatening seizures. Earlier this week, the cannabis oil, which eases his epilepsy, was confiscated at Heathrow because it's illegal. But today, the Home Office finally granted an emergency license, allowing his mother to get the drugs back.
Charlotte Caldwell, FaceTime video.
Ready?
Hello!
Charlotte!
Hello, Charlotte. Good morning.
Hi.
Listen, thank you so much for taking our call. We are contemplating trying to get Max treated with medical marijuana. So, obviously, you're a logical person for us to talk to.
Billy, he was hospitalised at 4 months old with his first seizure, and Billy just tried every pharmaceutical medication that you can think of. But in Billy's case, he continued to have seizures. I found the epileptologist in Chicago. What did I do here? And he said, have you ever thought about medicinal cannabis? I think it could be a good option for Billy. It took a number of months till we found the right dose for Billy.
Mm-hmm.
But normally Billy would say the seizure would last 12 minutes or something, or whatever the case was. It was like lasting 2 minutes. Because of Billy's severe developmental delay, I would have always had to go to Billy for a hug. Do you understand me?
Yes.
Yeah.
The first time that Billy came running towards me with his arms outstretched, he wanted a hug from me, and that was, I knew then, and I don't mean to get upset, Steph, but I knew then that was, his little brain was starting to heal, there was something changing.
There he is. Hi, Billy.
Hi, Billy.
Hello, darling boy.
Look at that
lovely smile.
He's amazing. It wasn't a fast fix. And we also have to remember, like, medicinal cannabis works for some kids.
Yes.
For some kids, it doesn't. I would never say it's a cure. What I would say is it controls Billy's condition. Thank you so much, guys. I'll talk to you later.
God bless. Have a great day. Lots of love.
Bye-bye. Didn't see that coming.
Didn't see that coming. Didn't see that coming.
What an incredible woman.
I think she hit every single nail, didn't she?
Yeah. It was interesting, the bits that actually touched me most was the hug.
Because we don't get that. Where's that drink?
Yeah. Oh, we're out of gin.
Help me. Right, I need...
When you take on a role of caring...
Oh, we're getting two. You do like cucumber, don't you?
Right. You have to have a professional cap sort of tipped at all times.
Right, I've got steak one or chicken there. Which one? Chicken, steak, steak. Which one?
Chicken, steak!
Chicken. Right, that says steak, that says chicken. You know, looking at the words, which one do you want to eat later? The steak, you definitely want,
yeah. Steak!
You definitely want the steak. Good choosing, well done, bub. Right, walking with me? Right.
He gets very anxious. He can get slightly overexcited.
Go down that way.
Go back! Shh,
go back. Go back!
Go back.
Giggle Max!
Giggle Max.
Go!
Little one, come here, come here.
Big one!
No! Little one, go, go.
Done!
Very good.
But he's very good when it comes to being able to listen and being able to follow instructions. So in that respect, we bounce off of each other and just enjoy the day together.
It's nice in the car. No, it's not funny. Mummy, it's not funny.
Go from this happy, bright, articulate, bubbly young man to suddenly nothing. I think that's one of the most frightening points.
Oh dear.
People would possibly underestimate parents of people with special needs, how much they have to put up their guards and their walls because they just break every day because they know that they might not get that same person back. I could go into him one morning and he might not be there. That's something that his mum and dad have had to live with since he was very, very young.
All right, let's get you back. Oh, dear.
So we know they are using a form of medical marijuana in America. Before we give Max anything, you know, anecdotal information is king. This chap called Sam, his epilepsy is very, very similar to Max's. And within days of taking medical marijuana, his seizures plummeted from 68 to zero with no side effects. He's actually recovered cognitive ability.
He's going to be able to give Max a voice.
I know.
To be able to tell us what it felt like.
I know.
And that's going to be quite...
difficult.
That's going to be quite hard work.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, OK, big dog. Hi, Sam.
I'm Steph. It's great to meet you.
And Dom.
Who's
absolute
this?
Pleasure. Thank you very much.
Hi.
Maisie.
Please, can I get anyone a cup of coffee?
Oh, that would be fantastic. Thank you very much.
Oh.
Same story as you. We've tried every medication that's on the market.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Some twice. If they helped, they didn't help for very long.
Yeah.
Or Sam got horrible side effects. We would always get periods of relative seizure control that never complete.
Right.
Apparently, I was having like 130 a day and having one every 3 minutes.
So how did you feel as a family that the suggestion that the one thing that might work for your son would be derivative of cannabis?
Initially, juxtaposing using cannabis medicinally for that and my experience with cannabis as a university student didn't really work very well.
Right.
Basically, it looked like there were two baskets, the CBD, the cannabidiol,
yep,
and the THC. THC makes you stoned.
Yep.
Scientists think that it's not good for developing brains, and
yep,
so I thought, my kid is not getting this.
Definitely.
So we were looking around for purified cannabidiol, purified CBD, and we bought, what do you think it does in tinctures?
Okay.
And we had them all tested in a lab, and not one of them had the amount of CBD that they promised.
And so we found ourselves feeling a little bit like we were down a rabbit hole, and we're saying, gosh, what we really need is a pharmaceutical-grade CBD, and we need to get some of that. Yeah.
That's it there.
And I'm the first one to try it.
So Sam has the oil. What were the changes? And how did you see it happen over the time?
Sam had 68 seizures the day before he was able to start trying that. Within 36 hours, he was down to about a dozen seizures. And 2 weeks later, he was down to one or two a day.
That really is amazing.
I was able to go on a zip line.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I was able to go to a science museum and enjoy it.
Yeah.
How much cognitive awareness, where did you have at the time? When did you start losing it? Do you recall any of what went on when you were having the seizures? And
how many questions do you need to ask?
Exactly.
Him?
Well, it's, yeah, I sort of want to ask them all.
Pretty much answers that whole question.
Really?
I don't remember much from when I was having seizures.
Right.
I remember, like, maybe brief moments, but that's about it.
Was there any pain involved? That's a really big one for me.
No.
Sam, it has been an absolute privilege to meet
you.
Thank you very much for
really
everything.
Has.
So much.
Thanks.
So much.
I was thrilled we met them. Absolutely thrilled we met. And very empowering to hear their story. It filled in quite a lot of gaps for me.
And it was lovely to be able to actually talk to Sam about what he does and doesn't remember, the good bits, the bad bits.
You know, I was terribly saddened by that because I thought, well, that's obviously the same for Max, that he just... I mean, he says, obviously, he said, I didn't know any different, which gives you comfort, but at the same time, there's no memory. Or that any memories he did have, they've kind of been shot away. And that in itself was terribly sad.
Sorry, do you want this? Go on then. Can I borrow that one? Can I borrow the rugby one? Can I borrow that one? Can I borrow this one?
I feel like as the years have gone by, like obviously with his condition and everything, I know that I need to spend a lot of time with him because he might not make old bones.
I'm not sure, I don't know. I'll come help you in a minute,
I see. Mummy always says to me, oh, he's not your burden. Like, I want you to have your own life. I don't want you to feel that you have to be there for Max. But I don't have to be there for Max, I want to be. Because he's my brother, he's a part of me, and I wouldn't want him anywhere else, really.
So far, anecdotally, CBD appears to work for some and doesn't for others and may not work for Max. It appears that adding back a tiny bit of THC, which of course is illegal in this country, does occasionally produce good results. Well, well, well.
Hey, little one. I'm Steph.
It's
lovely to meet you.
Hi, Hannah, Dom.
Well, Alfie and his family have been through this whole process.
This way. Wind our way through.
And
They are accessing a cannabis oil that does have some THC in it. That has been the trigger that seemed to work for him.
You set it up for Al. Feel it, Al. Have a big kick. That's it. You set it up for Al.
I went to see our consultant, and he basically said to me, don't talk to me about that again.
Shut
it's illegal. If you talk to me again, I shall get social services involved. Which I was like, okay.
It's a little strong.
A little strong. So I plucked up the courage and went to this new neurologist, and I said, I want to take Alfie to Holland. I want to find a doctor to treat him.
Why did you not just stick to just CBD on its own?
People with very aggressive genetic epilepsies need THC usually. Mm. Sometimes, like Alfie has 2 milligrams a day. It's a tiny, tiny amount. He has 2 drops a day, and it's enough to stop his seizures completely. When he doesn't have that, he does still have seizures.
And so at that stage, he's not getting any reaction,
no.
Any high, any...
No,
weird,
not at all, not at all. The only side effects he's had from all of this is good side effects. He's not been high. So we decided to come home. We took him off the THC. He became very unwell. Had a petition, as you know, on change.org. And so in the end, on the 19th of June, the Home Secretary made an announcement that we had our licences for Alfie. So he has a big dose of CBD and a very small dose of THC.
Okay, good boy.
Having seen the change in my child, I don't want anyone to suffer like we did.
Mm-hmm.
And if there's something that can help them, then they should have it. Do you mind if I ask you what you're going to do next?
My logical step in my head is saying, start with the CBD.
Definitely. Exactly where I'm going.
And see
what happens.
See
and then
what happens. Adding in the THC, that is the bit that we step into another world of one drop might be too much for Max.
Yeah.
It might need to be a millionth of one drop. Or he might need 3 or 4 or 5 drops.
As you say, it's got to be worth trying. Mm. Definitely.
I got a dragon! I just think we should tell him everything. Before we make... Hey! David, there you are. Hello.
How are you?
We're good. We're a little bit tired, but and full of information and overflowing, really. CBD pure, no THC.
Yes.
Our current thinking is that that's where we start. I think that's a good starting point. What do you think?
And as we've got a pharmaceutical grade pure CBD product likely to become available very soon in the UK, then I think that's where we should start with Max and see how we go grading that up as per guidelines. That's when we can get our hands on it.
Okay, so how do we do that?
So my understanding of this current process, and it's changing all the time, is that pure cannabidiol products are soon going to be prescribed for personal use. In terms of getting hold of it, my understanding is that the company which is making the pharmaceutical grade CBD is going to release amounts on compassionate grounds according to set guidelines. I've yet to see the full guidelines, but my view is Max is likely to meet those guidelines. And we hope to access them soon, as I say, on compassionate grounds.
Okay. And what would be your greatest hope for a result for Max on this?
I think we need to manage our expectations because we are hoping for an improvement in his epilepsy. But as I've said, sadly, it's profoundly unlikely that he would be seizure-free.
Yeah. We're not expecting any great miracles, but... everything's worth a try.
Yeah. So you look like you need a glass of wine and a lie down. So,
what you should do. All right. You're a superstar. Thanks, David. Speak soon.
Bye.
Enough. Okay. Good, we've got an agreement. On compassionate grounds, of course.
It's so harsh to hear it, though.
Darn it.
I thought it was just really harsh.
Mm-hmm.
I think David's point is very valid. You know, we're all looking for hope. We're all looking for a solution to everything, every illness, every condition, every ouchy pain that everyone has. And if there's a glimmer of hope, we'll grab it with both hands, but we mustn't grab it too early. And I think this is the message that, yes, there might be something here, but maybe it's not for Max's time. Maybe it's for the generation after him.
It's the question of what if, and I feel like it's a horrible question, and to dwell on that just causes pain, but what's happened has happened. You can't go back. You've just got to adapt to the situation and deal with it, I feel. But yeah.
Cranberry sauce, raspberry preserve, red currant jelly. Hello, my boy. Happy birthday.
Bunny, he's not bunny.
Hug for daddy. Woohoo! Oh, cool. Right, come and help yourselves. Come and help yourselves. Come and help yourselves.
Today's a day we never thought would actually happen. We are celebrating Max's 18th birthday.
Look at you!
Look at you,
Maxie. We're all just going to go bananas and act like children.
You've just hit my arse.
We visited Max's.
So we got him this far, and I think it's our job now to get him over the next bit and plan for the rest of his days.
Happy birthday! Anybody? Hello? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Maxie. Happy birthday to you.
Big blow.
And again.
It's almost like time has stood still while we've been doing this.
Wow!
It's been very emotionally very challenging.
Look at you!
Yes!
Hey!
Today!
Here's to Max. I think it's brought us all round as a family. And get lost in the reality of his condition.
Good man, well done.
All the things that are the negatives. Because I'm looking more closely, I'm seeing a lot more of the positives. And, you know, there are bits that I've forgotten that are joyful, really joyful. So it's real mixed bag. It's going to take a while for me to process it all.
Oh,
yes.
What does it say? Look, can you read it?
I know we're not going to fix him. We'll never reverse the damage.
Max,
do you want some more cake?
Yeah, I think quite a long time ago we came to the conclusion that there isn't going to be a cure.
No.
He's going to be like this for the rest of our life.
Yes.
So the question, will cannabis oil save our son's life?
Maybe.
I think it might. Will it cure him?
No.
No, I don't think so. But we're going to give it a try.
Do you want to have a go at the bouncy castle?
Bouncy castle!
Go on, then. Come on, then, my dear.
Mummy and Dad, we've got a bouncy castle!
We've got a bouncy castle, Maxie. Come on,
Mummy and Dad, we've got a bouncy castle!
Well, oh, my God, I think I'm going to be sick.
All right, Mummy and Dad, we've got a bouncy castle! I didn't tell you about the castle!
Who's Star Trek to me?
Come on, Squeech.
Holly.
In the last couple of weeks, the government passed a law making it legal to prescribe medicinal cannabis. For everybody sitting at home watching, they'll be under the belief that it's all been legalized. You can go and get a prescription, go and get your cannabis oil, and whoop-de-doo. That's not the case. It just hasn't happened.
It could be summer 2019 before Max gets his hands on the oil. By which time, it might be too late for him and all the other families with children, young adults. You know, you've got to remember that for 18 years, every night we've said goodnight to Max. We've no idea, going in the following morning, whether he'd still be alive. And do you know something? I'm exhausted from fighting, almost from the day he was born. We've done nothing but fight for him, fight for all the help we've got, fight for medication, fight for the right to try other medication. And here we are, we're still fighting.